Hey guys, Jeff Beal here. It is Friday. Thank God it's Friday, right? It's Labor Day weekend. Today is September the 4th. And today's topic is, again, how to boost your immune system. I've already covered 3 of the 8 bullet points. And today is how to maintain a healthy weight. And what is this notion about healthy weight? What is a healthy weight? And I just say, hey, maintain a healthy weight. That doesn't tell you much. So there are a couple ways that you can do that. I've written a bunch of stuff on the board, but before I go to the board, guys, there is one way to track if you're a healthy weight, and that is by a BMI or height to weight age chart. And so let me just use myself as an example. And I've actually lost some weight over the COVID-19 because of intermittent fasting, changed my workouts a little bit, learned a little bit more. But let's say I am about 6 foot tall. So I checked my height chart here. I go down to 6 feet. And so here's 6 feet. And I'm about 188, 190 pounds. And that is in the yellow area. And oh my gosh, I'm overweight. Do I look like I'm overweight? I've been told I've been underweight actually. So, and that's because I carry a little bit more muscle mass than I do body fat. Actually, a lot more muscle mass than I do body fat. So the body mass chart is a relatively good chart to do, but if for the very fit and the people that exercise a lot, this may not be the best chart to go by. And as a matter of fact, another chart that you should be doing to help determine if you have a healthy weight or not is maybe checking body fat. And they've got these really cool calipers. These are very inexpensive. They actually have these high-tech machines that you would stand on, and you grab these handles and it does a bioimpedance. And you know, these machines can cost up to like $5,000, and it gives you a nice printout and tells you what your body percent fat is. But body fat percent, guys, so what I'm looking at, what is considered normal? What considered normal for a man? So if, like for me, I'm gonna be 53 coming up on Monday, by the way. Essential fat, I wanna be 2 to 5% body fat. Excellent is somewhere between 15 and 17, and then good is 17 to 21, 21 to 24, poor is 27.5 or greater. And I'm just talking about myself. And then there's a female category as well. And I'm actually gonna post this on with this video to show you. But another way to do that, guys, instead, if you don't have these nice calipers, is if you check over here on the board, you got a pinch test. So if I can pinch a quarter of an inch, I'm gonna be 5 to 8% body fat. I actually took my body fat this morning and I'm about 8% body fat, which is probably one of the lowest as I've been in a while. And I happen to have a tape measure here to show you how to do that. So if you notice this caliper, it starts at 0. And when it opens up, it starts to go into a number. And this is actually in millimeters in thickness. And so what I've written on the board here, guys, is gonna be in inches. So I actually measured for men, we're gonna measure at the chest, the abdomen, and the thigh. And so for the chest, if I go on my chest here, guys, I'm gonna be measuring right between the nipple and the armpit, and it's gonna be a diagonal fold. And look, I can't grab too much there. And so that thickness is really like that much. And if I look at the tape measure at that much, that's about a quarter of an inch. And look, behold there. So, but I went through one by one. I did my chest, my ab, and then I also did my thigh. And it turned out to be, when I looked at on the chart here, and I found my total circumference sites were 20. So those 3 sites, between my chest, my ab, and my thigh, I got 20. And I looked over here in the scale, and this is a Ellington and Darden. These guys made it real easy. If you have the skin calipers, instead of having all these fancy equations, you can look on this chart that we have here, and lo and behold, I was about 8%. So that's one of the best body fat percents I've been in my lifetime. And I, not that I'm trying to impress you, I'm just trying to impress upon you. But guys, I know I'm kind of rambling on here, but the importance of being at a healthy weight is very important. And knowing your body fat is extremely important, because if you're over fat, I'm talking for men, I just went over that. If you're a man and you're over if you're over 24%, that's not good. If you're a female, and if you're over, and I'm talking like for 50-year-olds, if you're over 30%, that is not good. And so why is it not good? Well, because typically most people are going to hold their fat in their belly, and that's considered visceral fat. And the visceral fat is stored within the abdominal cavity. It's located near several vital organs. And because of that, it can kind of seep into those organs. And you've got the liver, the stomach, the intestines, and you've got all these different things that can come about of that. And look at this. I've even found here in a couple of studies from the Healthline, heart attacks and heart disease, type 2 diabetes, stroke, breast cancer, Alzheimer's. A lot of things are developed because of having visceral fat. And check this out. If you want to get the tape measure like I had before, and you want to go around your waist with the tape measure, if your waist and you're a female is 35 or greater, you're at a higher risk for health problems, the ones that I just mentioned. And if you're a man, if you're a male, and your waist is 40 inches or greater, that's also not good. So guys, you want to be checking yourself based on body fat percent. Just don't go by, and I'm actually going to post that chart that I mentioned before. So this BMI chart, I'm going to post it online so you can see it. If you're within the guidelines here, that's great. But if you are somebody that may not fall in the guidelines and you like, oh man, this is not right. I feel like I'm in good shape. I feel like I'm the best fitness of my life. And then I want you to do this pinch test. And if you don't want to, if you don't think the pinch test is that accurate for you, then come on up to the Mac and I'll be glad to check it. Any of our fitness instructors can check it. It's a very easy, quick test to administer. And I think the Caliper is so quick and easy. Every time I've redone it right after, I get the same results. Some of those bioimpedance things, I step on the scales, I step on it and I get like 10%. I step off. And then literally 30 seconds, I step back on and I'm like 18% body fat. I'm like, this is not accurate. And for whatever reason, I'm not sure what the reason is for that, but because it's not accurate, I just don't like that test sometimes. So some of the machines, if you get really expensive ones, then they're gonna be very accurate. If you don't, then they're not gonna be as accurate. So anyway, guys, hopefully you got something out of this video. If you did, please comment below. Let me know that you enjoyed it. And I will see you on Tuesday. I'm taking a break on Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, but I will make another video. And the next video is going to be, if you drink alcohol, speaking of alcohol, Labor Day weekend, be careful, guys. If you drink alcohol, do it only in moderation. So I'm going to talk about why, what alcohol can do to you, and making sure you do it in moderation. God bless you guys. Have a great Labor Day weekend, and we'll see you later.